Hey.
Huh?
Hey, up here. Inside your head. You can't see me, dummy. I'm the voice inside your head.
What?
Never mind. Listen, do you know what you're eating?
Yeah, a chocolate bar.
No. Do you know what you're actually eating? Look at the ingredients list for me. What's the first ingredient?
Chocolate.
Okay, that's okay. What's next?
Sugar.
Okay, added sugar, real healthy. What's next?
Cocoa butter.
All right, that's actually pretty good. Some good nutrients there. Okay, what's next?
Soy lecithin emulsifier.
Yeah, soy lecithin. You know what that is?
No.
So what is soy lecithin? Actually, the first question is, what is lecithin? It's a mixture of phospholipids and oil. Great. What's a phospholipid? Essentially, a phospholipid is a fat molecule that is able to dissolve in mixtures that contain both oil and water. So we're going to look at how a phospholipid is able to bind water and oil together. We're going to go through this in a very general sense. Let's start with a little deeper look into a phospholipid or fat molecule. We start with a glycerol group, which acts like the backbone of the molecule. Attached to it is a phosphate group. And in lecithin, there is a choline group attached to the phosphate group. Lastly, we have two fatty acid chains that are attached to the glycerol group. Now let's take a water drop and an oil drop. Normally, they will not bind. However, when we throw our phospholipid in, the phosphate group binds to the water drop, and the fatty acids bind to the oil drop. This process is known as emulsification, and lecithin is the great emulsifier. You'll find it in many processed foods, such as cooking sprays, and especially chocolate bars. So now that we know what lecithin is, what about soy? I have a separate video posted where I discuss soy in depth. I'll put a link to that video on the screen and in the description box below. In general terms, soybeans are processed to separate the oil and protein contained in them. Once that is completed, lecithin is then removed from the oil. Soy lecithin has some health benefits. It's high in choline, which is essential to cells. Without it, cell membranes would harden. Choline is also vital for healthy liver function, and it's now being sold as a dietary supplement. But make no mistakes about it, soy lecithin's main benefit is to the food industry. Its ability to emulsify and stabilize food give that food longer shelf life. And we know those three words make each and every food manufacturer salivate. One last tidbit for you folks. 90% of soy in America is genetically modified and goes through processing that exposes it to chemicals. Bottom line, soy lecithin has some health benefits. But if possible, you want to stay away from the genetically modified, try and stick to the organic.